Hi everybody. So I want to talk about current today. So the first thing you need to know about current is the formula for current, and this is given by I, which is the letter that we use for current, is equal to Q over delta T. And basically this says that the amount of current flowing through something is equal to charge flowing through it per second. So that being said, we can go ahead and say that the units are coulombs per second, but we go ahead and call these amps. So an amp is equal to a coulomb per second. So that being said, if I have 5 amps going through something, that's 5 coulombs per second going through that circuit or component or something. Now there's something you need to know about like direct current versus alternating current. So there are different types of current that we can have. An example of like direct current would be like a battery. An example of alternating current is like the electricity that you have in your house. And direct current says that like there's only flow in one direction. But alternating current has flow in different directions at points in time. So like things are electricity is transported at alternating current because it's cheaper to transport it that way, if I'm correct. And I think this is why batteries sort of get to be a little bit expensive. I'm not too sure about that, but that's just I think. Another thing you need to know is Kirchhoff's rules. So I guess somebody named Kirchhoff came up with some rules that I've held constant up until now. The first one is Kirchhoff's junction rule. So let's say I have like a circuit that's like traveling like this, right? And it divides up. So like circuit, like things can like travel. So like, let's say this is like my source, for example, and like the circuit has to be complete. So let's say I have this. So it's, so my current is traveling this way. So let's say I have 10. Let's say I have 10 amps traveling along there, right? But it hits like a bridge, right, or a fork, right? So some of the current goes this way, some of the current goes this way, of course, intuitively, right? Let's say I know that 3 amps end up going this way, and they want me to find out how many amps are traveling here. I know that it's 7 amps right off the bat, right? Because I know that I started out with 10 amps, and that split up into 2 areas, so I end up with this equation, right? So everything in, that's a good way to put it. All the current going in is equal to all the current going out. So this is all the current going in, this is all the current going out. So I'm able to say that I3 is equal to 7 amps. Cool. Pretty intuitive, pretty straightforward. Now, I want us to talk about Kirchhoff's like voltage law or like loop rule. So let's say I have another like circuit, right? Let's say I have something here. Let's say I have like a random component here. Let's say I have another one here. This is a resistor, by the way, I just drew that. But like, let's say my voltage here is like 25 volts, right? Now voltage, I want us to remember, is potential difference. So it's a difference, right? So that means that from here to here, my voltage is 25 volts. Now a lot of the time when you start getting into like complicated things, like you would set a ground somewhere maybe, which could be like here. But I just want to point out something that like, basically from here to here, there's a voltage difference. From here to here, there's a voltage difference. From here to here, there's a voltage difference. But all of those differences have to add up to that 25. So basically, Kirchhoff's loop rule says that the voltage of the source of a loop has to be equal to the voltage drop. So each of these cause a voltage drop, right? Because there's a difference from here to here. So we maybe start out with 25 volts, right? That's the difference here. So like, it's a difference, so like, I look at it as like, oh, it's not like this has 25 volts. It's the difference between here and here is 25 volts, right? So from here to here is some set value. From here to here is some set value. And from here to here is another set value. So that's a way you can look at it. Yeah, that's all we have right now. As always, if there wasn't anything that you didn't understand, go ahead and comment in the comment section. I might be able to address whatever questions you might have. Let's keep learning, okay? Thanks.